there have been such violent protests against the CAA?
Because of Hindu hate by Congress and the other opposition parties in India, and particularly from Pakistan, actually, who are the driving force behind these opposition parties. So Pakistan are feeling very embarrassed, in fact humiliated, and are shell-shocked after the Balakot airstrikes, after Article 370, and after the constant pounding they are getting on the line of control, the LOC. So to make themselves feel good, to make themselves feel strong, they have to tell lies about India, to blacken the name so that they feel better about themselves. And there's no better evidence for the role that Pakistan is having in this than the fact that there were houses bought up months in advance of the riots in Hindu areas with stones, piles of stones mounted on the roofs of these places, ready for just that moment where they could launch an attack. Here it was the announcement of CAA. That was the moment they decided, okay, we're going to make ourselves feel better by making India look really bad. So unless there was that coordination, that money pouring in to coordinate that whole supply chain to fuel and fund the riots, they would not have happened. As I said earlier, there have been previous amendments. This is the sixth amendment now, since the recent Citizen Amendment Act. There have been previous amendments. Different things have happened to provide more dignity to these religiously persecuted minorities. This is just the latest one. So it's the fact that Pakistan have been feeling so low about themselves that they've used this as the excuse to make India look bad. And unfortunately, the media is just lapping it up. Many of this media, they themselves are funded, being backed by Pakistan. What's really striking is that they've had so much media coverage on the anti-CAA protests. What about the pro-CAA protests? There have been so many massive pro-CAA protests that have had no media coverage. Take, for example, even the Z News telephone marathon, where people could ring up in support of CAA. 1.5 crore people rang up in support of CAA. That's 15 million people did that. But there's nothing mentioned about that side, the positive side. And in contrast, and kind of as in evidence for that bias in the media, what about the fact that there have been tens of millions of people persecuted, these minorities persecuted in the Islamic State for decades? Why have the protests against that not caught the media's attention? This has been going on for decades. Tens of millions of people have been killed, they've been raped, they've been abducted. And that's had no media protest. The media is totally biased. And unfortunately, things are not getting any better. You only have to look at what happened yesterday in the town of Nanak in Pakistan, where an angry, bloodthirsty Muslim mob pelted with stones a gurdwara and were demanding and chanting that all Sikhs must be exterminated from that city in Pakistan. So things are not getting better for the minorities in these Islamic State countries. And anyone who is supporting the anti-CAA protests, what they are effectively doing is they are supporting that angry, bloodthirsty Muslim mob wanting to exterminate Hind Sikhs in that city in Pakistan. That is what an anti-CAA protester is supporting.